Hello. In this video tutorial from the Oregon Health Sciences University Library, you will learn the difference between searching with keywords versus searching with subject terms in library databases. The first thing that's important to understand is what the two different kinds of searches are actually doing. Let's start with keyword searches. The first concept you need to understand for keyword searching is metadata. Metadata is all of the information attached to an item in a database. For an article, this data includes things like author names, article titles, abstracts and article text, journal title, and basically any other catalog information attached to an article. That means when you run a keyword search, any articles with your keyword or keyword phrase anywhere in the attached metadata will show up in your search results. This is a broad, somewhat unfocused way to conduct a search because it will bring up all kinds of things that you might not be interested in. For example, let's say that I'm looking for items about beef. If I do a keyword search, I might get things that have the keyword beef somewhere in the metadata, but the item might be something very different from what I actually want. In this case, my results might include beef-flavored cat food, which I'm not interested in for this search. Subject term searching is a little different. Subject terms are attached separately by catalogers who look at the article or item and try to determine what the article is actually about. Once they know that an article is about a particular topic, they use a predetermined vocabulary that they attach to the record. That means that when you search specifically for a subject term, you have the added value of human intelligence has determined that, in fact, this article really is about beef, rather than just having that keyword somewhere in the metadata. Here's another example. A keyword search for onions might give us these sour cream and onion chips, while a subject search gives us actual onions. Many of our searches include multiple items. Let's say we were searching for ingredients to make a beef stroganoff. If we use subject terms, we can be fairly confident that we'll find the right items. Whereas, if we are only searching with keywords, we might end up with a pretty unappetizing meal. You might be wondering that if subject searching is so much more precise, why would we use keywords at all? Well, there are a number of reasons that you want to run your searches with both keywords and subject terms. One reason is that not all articles ever get subject terms attached to them. For example, in the National Library of Medicine's Medline database, which you may be more familiar with as PubMed, there are about 35 million articles. Only around 30 million of those have subject terms attached. In this database, if you only search using subject terms, you would automatically be missing 5 million potentially relevant articles. Another reason is that because so many articles are constantly being added to databases, it can take catalogers months to add those subject terms. If you don't use keywords in your searches, you are probably going to miss all the most current articles on your topic in your search results. The takeaway from this is that if you want to do thorough research, you should always use both keywords and subject terms in your searches to get the most thorough and current results. One final thing to be mindful of when using subject terms in your search is that they occasionally get updated. This is a good thing. As our knowledge and understanding of topics change, so should our language. The potentially dark side of this process is that dated or offensive terminology are often still attached to older articles. For example, the term transgender person entered PubMed's medical subject heading system in 2016. Before that, it was transgendered persons from 2013 to 2015, and transsexualism from 2001 to 2012. Its previous history included terms we wouldn't use today, such as paraphilias and transvestism. You may run across some of these terms as you search through subject term systems. It's important to realize that this is the case, especially if you're doing research that includes historical topics. You may need to use older, potentially offensive terminology to find all the relevant articles for your topic. While subject systems try to adapt, it can be a slow-moving process. Librarians and catalogers continue to advocate for more inclusionary subject terms, but the reality is that while our systems continue to evolve with our understanding, there are still many relics from earlier times in databases and catalogs. To learn more about how to combine both your keyword terms and subject terms together for more effective database searching, please watch the Boolean Operators video tutorial located in the tutorial section of our library website. And as always, if you have any questions, please reach out to the library.